Hello.
Does that sound good? Hi, welcome to Together with Classical's fundraiser concert. We are currently live in New York City, in case you were curious about the traffic noises that you might be hearing. There's some celebration honks going around the city, it seems like. So if you hear that, it's because we're in New York and it's loud here in Midtown. And we are actually in Rare Violins of New York, wonderful friend and restoration shop. And actually Colin is currently playing on a cello on loan from Rare Violins. So special thanks to Rare Violins for letting us stream from here. And I thought I could tell you a bit about Together with Classical. I founded Together with Classical back in the pandemic. Ow, I should not be doing this, sorry. I forget that I've hurt myself and I just like banged on my, sorry. I founded Together with Classical in 2020, and it was actually this video that inspired me. Maybe some of you who are watching remember this video that I did on my YouTube, where I asked everyone, what is classical music to you? And when was your first experience with classical music? I had no idea that I would get over 1,700 responses, and everyone was so honest and open about their experiences, telling me in paragraphs, some of them were essays long, and I took 3 weeks to read through all of the responses, and I tried to make, you know, a 40-minute video about as many people's experiences as possible, but it made me realize that there isn't a platform or a place that I feel is welcoming to both people who are curious about classical music but don't play on the stage professionally, and also having professionals to exist together with amateurs, curious listeners, everyone in between. There isn't really a place where it really feels like Together with Classical Music. So that's how I came up with Together with Classical as a platform or community where we can support each other in various ways to make you feel welcomed to be part of classical music. I grew up not having peers understanding why I like to play on wooden blocks. And I remember sharing some of the similar experiences with some of you who shared that you don't feel very supported also. And so I just want to be able to do projects that could empower different voices of classical music. So that's how Classical Chats, the podcast series, began, was me inviting all kinds of people who love classical music to come on. So we've had very different kind of guests, anyone from very well-known established classical musicians like Midori, Gil Shaham, and also then talking to students, talking to scientists, talking to doctors who just love to play their instruments because they love it as a hobby. So I've been very, very happy and inspired to be doing Classical Chats. You might have noticed that we also started another project on YouTube, which is called Classical Bean. The first episode, I was very excited after many months of planning with my team to finally publish the first episode about classical music. You might have seen the first episode called Bach is Not Classical. And the hope for Classical Bean is very much inspired by my obsession at a time during the pandemic with TED-Ed videos, where I could learn about various subjects that I never thought I could through very approachable, accessible animations. And so that's the hope of this education series, Classical Bean. Some of you might have been one of the grantees, the grants recipients of our grants. This will be returning next year. Our hope is to fund as many people as we can to help them with their lessons, with instrument upgrades, or funding their concert projects. And so we have been able to do some of that. And I forgot to show you the graphics here. And so to everyone who has donated so far to Together with Classical, that is all the projects that you will be helping us continue and also build our team to be able to make more of these episodes and do more of these projects. So thank you very much to everyone who has donated already. I have not checked the latest amount, but our goal currently is to raise 5,000. I have no idea what the, not score, but what the what the donation amount right now is yet, but I will check in a little bit later. All the links will be in the description if you are looking for an alternate method to donate. And again, thank you very much for joining us on this live stream. And before I forget, Colin.
Hi.
So usually I do these live streams alone, and it's not as fun as doing it with friends. And
here's Colin.
We met through, actually, to give classical. He has been our outreach coordinator, and he was very instrumental, no pun intended, in coordinating the latest partnership with Cello Bello. And yeah, maybe you should introduce yourself.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Colin, and I'm the outreach coordinator for Together with Classical. Just a little bit about me. I began playing the cello when I was 10 after hearing a cello arrangement of Star Wars in my school music class. And I've just been playing ever since. Now I'm 18 and I'm a first year in the Columbia Juilliard Exchange program. Yeah, thank you again for being here.
Yeah, I am extra excited and biased because I went to Columbia Juilliard, so I was very excited when he got in. And so we're going to keep playing a few more pieces for you. This program actually was because of your request to play Fauré, which I have actually never done. So I thank you for having the opportunity to play some Fauré. Yeah, let's continue.
Thank you.
Yeah. Do you want to join me in sitting here and see what's thank you. I hope you enjoyed the concert program. In the middle of playing the first piece, I was like, wait, I introduced it as Fauré. Like, I was inspired to, and thanking you for the opportunity to play Fauré. But then I was like, wait, we're starting with Saint-Saëns. And that's because I got too nervous and did not explain to you the inspiration behind the program. So that was idiotic, and I'm sorry. It's weird. I meant to say this in the beginning, but basically, this is a very idealistic concert. And when we were trying to come up with a program, we were thinking, is there a theme? Is there like a type of music or type of, I don't know, or even a specific composer? And I was very happy that you said Fauré, but then also you showed me that you know Schumann. And anyone who knows me knows that I love Schumann's music. And I've actually always wanted to play Fantasie Stücke, the non-piano version, because there is a piano solo version, not version, but solo piece with the same name. So I was very happy to be able to do this with you. And I also know that it was final season. Yeah. And so we did not have, you know, lots of rehearsal time, but I hope you enjoyed this concert. I know I definitely had some misses, but yeah. And so the concept was idealistic. I start with the dream of a dream, the rêverie. I don't want to speak French and be wrong, but the Debussy piece, you know, starting off something dreamy and idealistic. And then those who know Chopin might have heard that Fauré was very inspired by Chopin, and Saint-Saëns was also related to Fauré in a sense, because when Fauré was 9, he met Saint-Saëns. So that was a fun fact and a good segue for me to be able to group these composers together. And some of you might remember that Schumann was very complimentary of Chopin and was the one who said hats off genius here with, I think, a review of Chopin's music. So they're all related, in case you're curious why this set of composer after listening to all the pieces. I'm just going to check the live stream because I have not seen it. I haven't done this in a while, this live streaming business. Yay! Yeah, so I guess this is it, unless you want to do a Q&A, but I will wait for a few seconds to see if anyone wants to do a Q&A. If not, then this will be it. I'm reading comments. Someone wants to know who made your cello. Do you know which cello you're playing?
This is Kurt Jones, Seattle, 2012.
Ah, so it's a new cello.
Yeah, it's not mine. I'm just playing it.
Okay, well, good to know. Let's see. I am just reading. There are a lot of really nice comments here, so thank you. I think there isn't really much of a Q&A, so I think you're off the hook. thank you. And we'll have this fundraiser going on for a while, so hopefully we can reach the target before the end of the year. Yeah. Okay. Bye.